Let's continue to learn how to name and write formulas for ionic compounds by taking a look at how to do this for compounds containing a polyatomic ion. Polyatomic ions are charged groups of two or more elements covalently bonded together. While each atom itself is not charged, the group as a whole has a charge. One very common polyatomic ion has the formula OH-, a polyatomic anion called hydroxide. It's formed from the combination of a hydrogen atom and an oxygen atom with an extra electron. Sulfate, SO4, with a negative 2 charge, is a combination of one sulfur atom and four oxygen atoms with two extra electrons overall. Other common polyatomic ions and their formulas are listed here, including ammonium, nitrate, carbonate, and phosphate. Since there are many polyatomic ions and their names are often similar, it's often helpful to consult a list of polyatomic ions when first learning to write their names and their formulas. So if you know the formula, how do you write the name of an ionic compound that contains a polyatomic ion? Well, quite simply, the same way you name any ionic compound. First, write the name of the cation, then write the name of the anion. Since polyatomic ions already have their endings changed, there's no need to change the ending to "-ide," as you do with single atom ions. In our example here, we just name the cation, calcium, then name the anion, carbonate. Here's some more practice. Since Na is sodium and OH is the polyatomic ion hydroxide, the name of NaOH is sodium hydroxide. But you may be more familiar with it as lye soap. NH4I is the formula for a compound containing the ammonium cation and the iodide anion, so its name is ammonium iodide. What do you think the name of this next compound is? Remember to name the cation first, then the anion. I'll give you a few seconds to think about it. Well, the Mg ion is magnesium, and NO3 is nitrate, so this must be magnesium nitrate. What about going the other direction? How do you take the name of a compound and write the correct formula if that compound contains a polyatomic ion? Again, to be honest, the process is the same as for simple binary ionic compounds. First, write the symbol for the cation, then write the symbol for the anion. Since ionic compounds are always neutral, we'll need to have as much total positive charge as negative charge. So we'll often need to add subscripts to each ion so that whichever ion needs more than one of that ion to exactly cancel the charge. When more than one of a polyatomic ion is needed in the formula, you must include parentheses around the polyatomic ion before you add your subscripts. The polyatomic ion acts as a group, so you cannot change the subscripts within the polyatomic ion itself. For instance, you cannot change the formula for sulfate from SO4 to SO8 because you need more charge to cancel. Don't mess with the polyatomic ion's formula. Just use parentheses and subscripts outside those parentheses. Let's look at a couple of practice problems together. Calcium sulfate is an example of an ionic compound with a polyatomic ion in it. Calcium sulfate is known as gypsum, G-Y-P-S-U-M, which is the substance that blackboard chalk is made of. Anyway, calcium, the ion, has a positive 2 charge. Now remember, that's because calcium, the atom, is a group 2 metal with 2 valence electrons. So here's the dot diagram for it. When calcium forms the ion, the calcium ion, it loses these 2 electrons and becomes positively charged. Sulfate is SO4. That's a group, a polyatomic ion. It's sulfur and 4 oxygen atoms bonded together, covalently bonded together, with an overall charge of negative 2, because they've gained 2 electrons to make that polyatomic ion. Well, if calcium has a charge of positive 2 and sulfate has a charge of negative 2, then we only need one calcium ion and one sulfate ion in order to write the right formula, because the positive 2 charge of calcium exactly cancels out the positive 2 charge of sulfate. Here's another example. Magnesium hydroxide. Magnesium hydroxide is the active ingredient in the antacid milk of magnesia. Magnesium is a group 2 metal, so it forms a positive 2 ion when it loses its 2 valence electrons. Hydroxide is a polyatomic ion, OH. It's one oxygen bonded to a hydrogen atom, and overall it has a charge of negative 1. So when we make the formula, we're not just going to be able to use one of each ion, because the charge of magnesium is twice as big as the charge of hydroxide. So what we need is another hydroxide in magnesium hydroxide. So the formula would be Mg, and then we need to use parentheses, because we've got two of the hydroxide groups, two of the polyatomic ion. Subscript 2 goes outside the parentheses. So the correct formula for magnesium hydroxide would be Mg with parentheses, OH, and then close the parentheses, 2. Many nitrogen-based fertilizers contain ammonium nitrate. Now, ammonium here is a polyatomic ion, NH4. It has a positive 1 charge. Nitrate is also a polyatomic ion. Nitrate is NO3, and it has a negative 1 charge. So hopefully what you recognize here is that the positive charge of ammonium exactly cancels out the negative charge of nitrate. So the formula for ammonium nitrate is NH4, NO3. And this is one of those rare cases where you have an ionic compound that has only nonmetals in the formula, but it is formed from two ions, ammonium and nitrate. Aluminum sulfate is our last example. Aluminum has 3 valence electrons. When it loses those 3 electrons, it forms an ion with a positive 3 charge. Sulfate is SO4, and it has a negative 2 charge, just as it did back with calcium sulfate. And we can see here that we've got a positive 3 charge for aluminum and a negative 2 charge for sulfate. So in order to get a formula that's neutral, we're going to need more than one of both of these ions. The least common multiple of 3 and 2 is 6. And in order to get a positive 6 charge, what we'll need is 2 aluminum ions. And to get a negative 6 from the sulfate ions, we're going to need 3 sulfates. Sulfate's a polyatomic ion, so we have to use parentheses whenever we have more than one. And as you can see here, 2 times the positive 3 charge gives us a total of positive 6 in charge, and 3 times the negative 2 charge gives us a total of negative 6 in charge. And so the 2 aluminums exactly cancel out the charge of 3 sulfates. So the correct formula for aluminum sulfate is Al2, open parentheses, SO4, close parentheses, 3. Thank you for watching this video on how to write the names and formulas for polyatomic ionic compounds. If you find yourself having trouble naming compounds that have polyatomic ions in them, please review this video, your notes, and the appropriate pages in your textbook, or post a question in the comments on this YouTube video.